Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome everyone. Today I will discuss with you the theory of revenue, and this is the 8th module of this lecture series. Revenue refers to the income obtained by the firm through the sale of goods. The amount of money that a producer receives in exchange for the sale pursued is known as revenue. For example, if a firm gets 50,000 from the sale of 100 product, then the amount of 50,000 is known as revenue. And you know that the cost and revenue of a firm determine its nature and level of profit. And in the last lecture, we have already discussed about the costs. Costs refer to the expense incurred by a producer for the production of a commodity, whereas revenue denotes the amount of income which a firm receives by the sale of its output. Here, revenue concepts are concerned with the total revenue, average revenue, and margin revenue. And I am sure after completion of this module, you will be able to learn the concept of revenue, which will include TR means total revenue, MR margin revenue, and AR average revenue. The relationship between AR and MR, the significance of concept of revenue in economics, and economic profit versus accounting profit. Even we'll also try to discuss, and you will learn about the break-even analysis. Now let us discuss what is revenue. So revenue means the sale received of the quantity or output produced by a firm. It's also called as sale proceeds. It refers to the amount received by a firm from the sale of given quantity of a commodity in the market. What firm receives after selling the commodity, that is known as the revenue. The formula of revenue is quantity multiplied by price. The total quantity multiplied by total price will be the total revenue of a firm. The quantity produced by the firm and the price of quantity, market price basically, is equal to revenue. So we can calculate revenue, the quantity multiplied by price is equal to revenue of a firm or a producer. Now, revenue is very important concept in economic analysis. I've already discussed with you that revenue determines the nature and level of profit of a firm. Revenue concept are concerned with three important concept already stated: total revenue, average revenue, and margin revenue. Now let us discuss one by one in detail. Total revenue is the total receipts a seller can obtain from selling of goods or services to the buyers. That is the total revenue. It can be written as P multiplied by Q. P means price multiplied by quantity, which the price of the goods multiplied by the quantity of sold goods equal to revenue. Let us discuss with the help of following figure about the total revenue. See, on the x-axis we have the output here. and y-axis revenue. And this red line shows the total revenue, TR, which is equal to price multiplied quantity. This shows that as the output increases, revenue will also increase. Positive and proportional relationship between output and revenue. As output increases, revenue will also increase. When the firm increases production as well as output increases, the revenue will also increase at the same proportion. Not same proportion, but revenue will also increase as the output will increase. The total revenue is the sum of all sale receipts in income of a firm. Next, average revenue. Average means per unit. Average revenue refers to the revenue per unit of output sold. Average revenue refers to the revenue per unit of output sold during a given period of time. It plays a role in the determination of firm's profit. When firm calculates its profits, the firm wants to determine the profit, the average revenue play a very important role. Per unit profit is average revenue. The firm generally seeks produce the quantity of output that maximize the profit. Now, average revenue is equal to price of per unit. That is equal to also total revenue. Now, the relationship between average revenue and margin revenue we'll discuss. Under the perfect competition, the average revenue of the firm is horizontally and straight line. Perfect competition, we mean that situation of a market structure where homogeneous products are available. All products are homogeneous in nature. You cannot differentiate one product with another product. Perfect competition means the customers has the full knowledge about the market. In the market, firm can freely enter or exit. There is no restrictions. But firms are so small that they cannot influence the prices. Means firms are the price taker. Firm cannot determine the price. Price will be fixed or determined by the industry. So let us discuss with the help of this table. Total revenue, average revenue, and margin revenue under perfect competition. Now, here perfect competition, I have told you, because the products are homogeneous in nature, that's why price will be also equal homogeneous. Means the price of the product will be same. One product will cannot differentiate with another product. The quality and quantity of the product remains same. There is no change in the price of a product. For example, a pen, rupees 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. And the quality of pen, the brand is same. There is no change. Quantity now. Revenue means price multiplied quantity. 1, 10. 2 quantity. You know that the price again second unit remains same. But total revenue because of price multiplied quantity. So 10 multiplied by 1, 10. 10 multiplied by 2, 20. Then 10 multiplied by 3, 30. Here if you sell fourth unit of the commodity, then price is same, 10 multiplied by 4, but then 40. If fifth quantity firm has, you know, that's sold in the market, then 10 multiplied by 5, then 50 is, you know? So, and like on. So as the quantity increases, revenue also increases. Total revenue means price multiplied by quantity. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 is the quantity. Now, average revenue. I have already stated, average revenue means per unit revenue. And average revenue can be calculated total revenue divided by the quantity. Total revenue divided by quantity. Total revenue here, 10. Quantity, 1. 10 divided by 1, then we have 10. Then next unit, 20, total revenue 20, quantity 2, again 10. 30, total revenue we have 30, quantity 3, so 30 divided by 3, again 10. Quantity, here 40, sorry, 4, but the total revenue 40, then 40 divided by 4, then 10. There's a 10, 10, 10, 10. Average revenue is 10. Even if the total revenue is 70, but the quantity sold by the firm is 7, so 70 divided by 10 is 10. 10, 10, 10. But this is very interesting. In the margin revenue, average revenue and margin revenue will be equal in case of perfect competition. There is no difference between average revenue and margin revenue. Although margin revenue can be calculated by the total change in revenue due to change in quantity. Revenue is dependent factor. It is depend upon quantity. So total revenue divided by total quantity is equal to margin revenue. Change in total revenue due to change in quantity. Now total revenue is 10, for example. And quantity 1. When we change 1 to 2, total quantity change, there's a 1 to 2, the total revenue change, 10 to 20, 20 minus 10 is 10. Margin revenue is 10. Similarly, at this third unit, 30 minus, then now 20 to 30. Again, the change is 1 and 30 minus 20, 10. Similarly, 40 minus 30, 10. 50 minus 40, 10. 60 minus 50, 10. 70 minus 60, 10. So 10, 10, 10. Average revenue and margin revenue is same. Now, let us discuss with the help of the diagram. But before that, the firm is the price taker. I have told you, the firm is a price taker in case of perfect competition. And firm demand is infinity elastic. Small change in price, there will be infinity in demand. As the firm sell more and more at given price, the total revenue will increase, but the rate of increase in the total revenue will be constant. Since that's why AR will be equal to MR. As more and more given price of its total revenue will increase, but the rate of increase in total revenue will be constant. Since AR is equal to MR, each firm has to take the market price as given and sell its quantity at the ruling market price. The market price play important role here. The firm cannot fix the price, and the market price determined through the demand and supply forces of the market. Demand and supply forces of the market. So firms are price taker, not a price maker. Industry is the price maker. Firms are the price taker. Now we can discuss with the help of this diagram. As I have stated you, that here AR is equal to MR. You cannot differentiate average revenue with margin revenue because they remain constant. On the x-axis, we have the quantity, and y-axis, we have price. And this P is average revenue curve. In case of perfect competition, when products are homogeneous in nature, when firms are the price taker, not price maker, then revenue curve in perfect competition will be horizontal to the x-axis. Here, price 10 of each quantity. Price is here, OP is the price. AR is equal to MR. Average revenue is equal to marginal revenue. Now, unlike next to the average revenue and marginal revenue under imperfect competition, we are discussing the shape of AR and MR under different market structure. First, we have discussed about the perfect competition. Now, AR and MR under imperfect competition. Imperfect competition is a market structure where heterogeneous product will be there. The product will not homogeneous. The product can differentiate on the basis of their maybe shape, color, packaging, and so on. Even the price, maybe there will be variations. So, unlike under perfect competition, a firm under imperfect competition, such as under monopoly and monopolistic competition, can sell more only by lowering its price. In perfect competition, if you want to increase the sale quantity, so the price has to be decreased. Higher the price, lower the demand, and lower the price, higher the demand, even monopoly and monopolistic competition. That's why the demand curve or average curve in these markets, in imperfect market, the AR curve will be downward sloping. It will not be horizontal like perfect competition, because of demand. Average revenue curve is also equal to price, and it also refers to the demand of the product. Average revenue curve is also equal to the demand and the price of the commodity. Therefore, average revenue curve will be downward sloping. Now, let us discuss with the help of this table the total revenue, average revenue, margin revenue under imperfect competition. We'll discuss with the help of this table. Now, see, the first column of this table is quantity. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, price of the product is not same like the perfect competition. Here, higher the price, lower the demand, and lower the price. If you want to sold more commodity, then the price should be less. So maybe the price of the first unit is 10, but second 9, then 8, then 7, then 6, then 5, then 4, then 3. But the total revenue formula remains same. Meaning why? Total revenue is equal to price multiplied by quantity. Price 10, quantity 1, 10. Price 9, quantity 2, 18. Price 8, quantity 3, 24. Price 7, quantity 4, 28. Price 6, quantity 5, 30. Price 5, quantity 6, again 30. And then 4, 7. Quantity 7, 28. And then 24. Average revenue. Average means per unit. Total revenue divided by quantity. Total revenue 10, quantity 1, 10. Total revenue 18, quantity 2, 18 divided by 2, 9. Total revenue 24, quantity 7, 3, it means 8. Total revenue 28, quantity 4, 7. Here, total revenue 30, quantity 5, average revenue 6. Again, total revenue 30, quantity 6, average revenue will be 5. Here total revenue 28, quantity 7, 4 and 3 and so on. Here is one thing is very, very interesting. The average revenue in the initial stages is the first for the first unit very high. Then it start decreasing. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5 and 3. But it will never be 0 or negative. But in case of margin revenue, it may be 0 and it may be negative after some time. Now, margin revenue. Margin revenue can be calculated by change in total revenue. Change in total revenue due to change in quantity. Here, 1, quantity, total revenue 10, so 0 minus, earlier we don't have the output total revenue, so this is 10. Now, when we sell next quantity unit of the product, 1 to 2, total revenue increase 8, 10 to 18, it means 18 minus 10, 8 is the marginal revenue. Change in total revenue due to change in quantity. Similarly, 24 minus 18, when the output sold by the firm 3 to 2 to 3, then 24 minus 18, 6. 28 minus 24, 4. The fifth unit, 30. But change here, 30 minus 28, 2. But here's no change in the total revenue in the sixth unit. 30, so 30 minus 30 is 0. But seventh unit, here total revenue 28, it means 28 minus 30 minus 2. 24 minus 28, it means minus 4. So let us explain with the help of diagram. This first diagram, here we have the revenue y-axis, x-axis we have output. Now, see, the shape of both, in the both market, whether the monopolistic market or monopoly. Monopoly means when there is a single seller. Monopoly, when you don't have the close substitute of the product in the market. But monopolist is price maker. Here, monopolistic competition, this concept has been given by E.H. Chamberlain. We'll discuss in next lecture about the this monopolistic competition or the monopoly in coming lecture. But monopolistic competition we mean with large number of buyers and sellers. But in case of monopoly, only one seller. And here the product has no close substitute, but here the product in case of monopolistic competition are, you know that they are closely substitute. There are lot of pens in the market. There are lot of, for example, paste are in the market. And any commodity you want to purchase, that commodity has close substitute available. Whether you can use X commodity or Y commodity or Z commodity, they are similar, but you can differentiate only on the basis of their color, maybe taste, maybe brand, maybe packaging, maybe shape. But monopoly, only one seller, and the commodity he is selling has no close substitute available in the market. So monopolistic competition, average revenue curve downward sloping, monopoly the same, average revenue curve is downward sloping, but it will be more steeper. The average revenue curve in case of monopoly will be more steeper as compared to monopolistic competition. In monopolistic competition, it will be some flatter. The average curve will be flatter. In case of monopoly, it will be more steeper as compared to the monopolistic competition. And I have already stated you, average revenue also equal to demand and price. Average revenue is equal to also demand and price. So the difference between both average revenue curve in case of monopolistic competition or monopoly, the average revenue curve in monopoly will be more steeper as compared to the monopolistic competition. Now let us discuss something more. Average revenue curve and demand curve are the same, I have told you. A buyer's demand curve graphically represents quantity demanded by the buyers at the various prices. In the other words, it shows the various level of average revenue at the different quantities of goods are sold by the seller. So you cannot differentiate between AR and the shape of average revenue curve and the demand curve. Therefore, in economics, it is almost same average revenue curve. Also, we can say the demand curve of the firm. Let us discuss next important concept, that is the marginal revenue, MR, marginal revenue. Marginal revenue is the additional revenue that will be generated by increasing the product sales by one unit more, additional unit. When you sell the additional unit of the product, there will be a change in total quantity, total revenue, which is called as margin revenue. In a perfectly competitive market, the additional revenue generated by selling an additional unit of good is equal to price the firm is able to change the buyer to the goods. The margin revenue is additional income generated from the sale of one more unit of a goods or services. So it is additional income generated from the sale of one more unit of a good or service by the producer. To calculate the change in revenue, we simply subtract the revenue figure before the last unit was sold from the total revenue after the last unit was sold. We have already discussed that how the margin revenue is equal to change in total revenue due to change in quantity sold. Like this previous diagram, let me show you the this margin revenue. We have already discussed this change in total revenue due to change in quantity 1 to 2, then 18 to 10. This is margin revenue. 18 to 24, 24 minus 18, 6 is the margin revenue. 28 minus 24, 4 is the margin revenue. But here, like average revenue, in the initial stages, margin revenue will be high, 10, 8, but it starts with increase in quantity selling in the market. And after some point, it will be zero. Total revenue and margin revenue, average revenue belt will never be zero, but it after some time it will be zero, and then it will be negative. When total revenue will be maximum, it will be zero. When total revenue starts decreasing, margin revenue will be negative. When total revenue is increasing, the margin revenue will be positive. But when total revenue will be maximum, margin revenue become zero. And after some time, when the total revenue start reaching decreasing, the margin revenue will be negative. So let us discuss with the help of. But here, in case of perfect competition, because of average revenue is equal to margin revenue, so we cannot differentiate average revenue and margin revenue, it will be horizontal. But in case of imperfect competition, it will be negative slope, it will be downward slope in sloping, and then it will become zero and then negative. But in case of perfect competition, because of we have the homogeneous product, you cannot differentiate one product with another product, so marginal revenue will be equal to average revenue. We have already discussed with the help of a table. But in case of monopolistic competition and monopoly, this will be, this can be zero and it will be negative also. Again, the monopolistic competition and monopoly, the difference in both curve is, you can differentiate with the help of some steepness, elasticity. The monopolistic competition, the revenue via marginal curve in monopolistic competition will be more elastic as compared to monopoly. In case of monopoly, it will be less elastic. It will be more steeper as compared to monopolistic competition. In monopolistic competition, the marginal revenue will be some flatter, or it will be more elastic as compared to the monopolistic, as compared to the monopoly. So hopefully you are able to understand that what is the difference between the both, even the margin revenue curve, average revenue curve. In imperfect competition, AR or MR will be downward sloping, but in case of monopoly and monopolistic competition, in the monopoly it will be more steeper, whether the average revenue curve or margin revenue, as compared to monopolistic competition. In monopolistic competition, MR will be some more elastic. Let us discuss the average revenue and margin revenue under the oligopoly. Oligopoly is a market structure. We'll discuss all market in detail in coming lecture. But just briefly, oligopoly is a market structure where there are only few sellers. Maybe 10. 2 to 10. When there are two producers in the market, we can say duopoly, special case of oligopoly market. But more than 2, less than 10, we can call oligopoly. Few but big sellers, large in size, and the demand curve of a firm under oligopoly is not supposed to be smooth. I'll show you with the help of a diagram. But before that, in demand curve has kink K at the point of P. Demand curve indicate the price policy of the firm. Here, although this kink demand curve we'll discuss later, is dwelt by Hall and Hitch and M. Paul Suisi. If the firm increases the price above this price kink, his rival will not follow by the other firm, and consequently his sale and profit will suffer. Meaning why? There is an assumption that, for example, if we have the 10 or 7 producer in the market, big producer in the market, like the automobile company or any case can be there, when the producers are few but they are big in size, they are large in size. Now, what happened in this market, that you can assume, there's an assumption that suppose any firm among the 7 producers increase the price of the product. If the firm will increase the price of a product, the other firm will not follow that strategy. If A firm will increase the price, A firm will increase the price, then B, C, D, E will not increase the price. And higher the price, lower the demand. The firm which will increase the price, that will be in a loss due to higher the price and demand will be low. But other firm, because of they will not increase the price, so they will be in a profit. That's why after some time this firm will decrease the price. But if this firm will decrease the price, the other firm will follow the same strategy. If the firm, on the other hand, contrary, if the firm lower the price, the rival firm will it by the following same strategy. The other firm will follow the same strategy. All other firm will decrease the price. So there's a price rigidity in case of oligopoly. It means price will fix at a particular point, which is called as the kink. demand curve. Therefore, the firm cannot gain more by decreasing the price. When there is a kink, the average revenue curve and marginal revenue curve will be discontinued at the point of kink. So let us see with the help of next diagram. The gap between the marginal revenue depends upon the revenue elasticity of upper and lower portion of the kink demand curve. This can be shown like this. Now let us see this diagram. Now this D, E and this D, this dark black is the kink demand curve which I have stated in the previous slide. And the price will fix here, P star and Q star is the price. Now almost E is the rigidity price and the price remain here only. If I have told you that any firm will increase price, say P to P14 here, then what will happen? That firm, the quantity of that firm will be decrease in the market because of the high price and lower the demand. So after some time, that firm will decrease the price and the price remain here only key, E point, which is called as kink price, kink demand curve or kink, rigid price. But if that firm will decrease the price from the P star here, all firm will decrease the price and again the point become here key. So this is the assumption that as the price of one firm will increase, other will not follow this strategy, and if that firm will decrease the price, other firm will follow the same strategy. So this, that's why this D, E, T in demand curve, basically this part we have already discussed in demand curve. This is the more flat, which is indicate the market demand curve, and this is the individual demand curve. If you see this D2 demand curve, this is the individual demand curve, which is steeper, which is less elastic demand curve. And if you see this D and D1, this line, dotted line, if like this, if you draw the demand D2, D1, this is the market demand curve. So we can see that this kink demand curve, the demand curve in oligopoly, is basically the combination of market demand curve and individual demand curve. See, because of this demand curve is the combination of two demand curve, market demand curve, individual demand curve, that's why there is it. And this is also average revenue curve. Our focus is to discuss the average revenue curve. So demand curve is equal to average revenue. This is also equal to average revenue curve, AR. That's why MR is the broken part. Here's the broken part, 2MR. Why? Because of two demand curve. For this, this is margin revenue curve, and for this is margin revenue curve 2. So two margin revenue curve here because of this kink demand curve. Now this gap between this broken part of MR margin depend upon the elasticity of two demand curve. If it will be more elastic, there will be less gap between these. This will be, if the demand curve will be more elastic, then less gap. If less elastic, then there will be more gap between 2MR curve. So equilibrium here, we'll discuss later on that. For equilibrium condition, we have the one condition that MR should be equal to, and you know that MC and MC cuts MR from below, we'll discuss later on. But this here will be an equilibrium in case of oligopoly. But simple, our topic is to understand the average revenue. So average revenue curve will be kink and marginal revenue curve will be broken in two parts. Why it will be broken? Because of it is the two, there is two demand curve, and the gap between MR depends upon the elasticity of demand curve. Now let us discuss the relationship between AR and MR. So already we have discussed average revenue, the per unit output or per unit revenue, whereas total revenue is quantity, price multiplied by quantity, average revenue multiplied by quantity. So this average revenue multiplied by quantity, 1 multiplied by 20, 22, 21 multiplied by 2, 42, and then 20 multiplied by 3, 60, 19 multiplied by 4, 76, 18 multiplied by 5, 90, and so on. 13 multiplied by 10, 130. And margin revenue is the difference. Change in total quantity due to change in, change in total revenue due to change in quantity. So revenue increased 22 to 42. There is 20, 22, 0 minus 22, so 20. 60 minus 42, 18. 36 minus 60, 16. 90 minus 76, 14. 102 minus 90, 14. 112 minus this, 12. So this is, there is a relationship between AR and MR. Now let us discuss what is the significance of the average revenue curve and the revenue curve basically in the economics. Why it is important, why we are discussing the concept of revenue like AR, MR and total revenue. The concept of MR and AR both together constitute a powerful analytical tool in economic analysis. Average revenue is the price of per unit we know. And to find out whether the firm earns supernormal profit or normal profit or in a loss, the knowledge of AR is very, very important. You should know that about the knowledge of average revenue. Only then we can calculate the profit of the firm or losses of the firm. If AR is tangent equal to AC, then there will be normal profit. Then average revenue is equal to tangent with average cost. Is AR is equal to AC, then there will be normal profit. But if average revenue is above AC, average cost, average revenue will be more than average cost, there will be supernormal profit or abnormal profit. If average revenue is greater than average cost, there will be supernormal profit to the firm. But if average revenue is less than average cost, then there will be loss. So we'll discuss in the market structure all these things in detail with the help of diagram. So when average revenue is below the average cost, there will be loss. This will also helpful in decision making. That firm has to be go with this production or there is some changes required. Now, the concept is also helpful in determining the equilibrium of the firm. You know that the aim of every firm is to obtain the maximum profit, maximum output. The equilibrium of firm is very, very important. And if now margin revenue is equal to greater than marginal cost, there will be profit. So profit equilibrium firm can be calculated with the help of margin revenue. So margin revenue curve we should know. When margin revenue curve is greater than marginal cost, there will be profit. When margin revenue is less than marginal cost, there will be loss. And if marginal cost is equal to margin revenue, there will be equilibrium position. Now the concept is also helpful. The concept of revenue is also helpful to indicate the entrepreneurs whether the firm possesses the excess capacity or not. Excess capacity means the optimum, actual optimum output minus actual output. Monopolistic competition, we'll discuss what is the excess capacity. Simply, the actual output, optimum output minus actual output is known as the excess capacity. Under perfect competition, production will be carried on up to the minimum point of long run average LAC, long run average cost. Therefore, excess capacity is not possible. So we can know with the help of the revenue curve only, the concept of revenue only. However, under imperfect competition, monopoly or monopolistic competition, the firm can earn more than by reducing the output cost. We have already discussed that if you want to increase the sale, then increase the demand, then price has to be decreased. So production will not be carried on up the minimum point of long run average cost curve in case of imperfect competition. Now, in fixing the price of the factor of production, land, labor, capital in the market, average revenue and margin revenue concept are very, very useful to fix the price of factor of production. We have already discussed, we have four factor of production: land, labor, capital and entrepreneurs. So during the fixing of their price, one must have the knowledge about the AR and MR concept. Factor pricing, the average revenue curve become average revenue productivity curve, the margin revenue curve become the marginal revenue productivity curve, we'll discuss later on. Now let us discuss briefly about the, so this was about the revenue and profit are interrelated. So let us discuss briefly about the profit. The basic concept of profit is very simple. Profit is equal to revenue minus cost. Profit is equal to revenue minus cost. The revenue equal to proceeds of the sale. Proceeds from the sale. After sales, what you have the money in your hands, that is equal to revenue. And the cost are what is paid for the input. What you paid for the basis. So labor in form of base, land, rent, capital interest and other materials. So that is the cost. So profit is a benefit or gain, usually monetary terms. Profit is a benefit or gain, usually in monetary terms, in money terms. Profit, total revenue minus total cost, is known as the total profit. Total revenue minus total cost. When total revenue is equal to total cost, then maybe there is no profit, no loss. When total revenue is more than total cost, there will definitely profit. So the reward of entrepreneurs will give the profit. Normal profit, the minimum amount required to keep a firm in its current line of production. Normal profit, we'll discuss in next lecture what's the normal profit in the case of market when we have the perfect competition or monopoly or monopolistic competition. That's why we are discussing these concepts, that what is the normal profit, supernormal profit or abnormal profit. Second one, supernormal profit or abnormal profit. The profit made over above normal profit. Abnormal profit may be exist situation when firms have the market power. More market power means more profit. So market power is very, very important. Market control, how much you have the market control. Subnormal profit, below the normal profit. Firm may not exist the market even if the subnormal profit made, if they are able to cover the variable cost. So it's very compulsory to sustain in the market, you must cover the variable cost. Below the variable cost, if you have the shutdown point, the subnormal profit may be temporary or perceived as such. It depends. So let us discuss briefly some more topic, that is economic profit versus accounting profit. Economists measure a firm economic profit as the total revenue minus all the opportunity cost, that is explicit minus plus implicit cost. Economic profit is total revenue minus explicit plus implicit cost. Whereas accounting is measured only the total revenue minus only explicit cost. They ignore the implicit cost. Accounting profit means total revenue minus explicit cost. Implicit cost, self owned resources, self-employed resources, payment made to the self-employed resources and self-owned resources will not include in accounting profit. Whereas in economic profit, both explicit as well as implicit cost will be included. That's why the total revenue exceed both explicit and implicit cost, the firm earn economic profit. Economic profit is always smaller than the accounting profit because of economic profit include, you know, that explicit and implicit costs also. Accounting profit equal to total revenue minus accounting cost only. So total revenue, we have discussed the amount a firm receives for the sale of its output is the total revenue. Total revenue, the amount of a firm receives for the sale of its output is the total revenue. Total cost, the market value of the inputs a firm uses for the production, whether the land, labor, capital, or other raw materials. The total payment made to all these factor of production and non-factor of production is equal to total cost. And profit, the firm's total revenue minus total cost is the total profit. Profit is the total revenue minus total cost. Now, the break-even analysis. We'll discuss briefly what is the break-even analysis. Break-even analysis means, is a break-even analysis a point, we'll discuss with the help of a diagram, where firm makes no profit, no loss. Break-even a point where firms has makes no profit, no loss. The position where no profit, no loss is known as the break-even point. The point where total revenue is equal to total cost means break-even point. Break-even point. The point where total cost equal to the total revenue is known as the break-even point, as explained earlier. Now see, we can explain break-even point with the help of this diagram. This green line, this is the total revenue curve. This green line is the total revenue curve and blue is the total cost curve. Revenue can be zero, it start from zero and it start increasing, very increasing rate up to here, and after this point it start decreasing. Total cost is cannot be zero, and why? Because of this R tier. This is the total fixed cost. This red line shows the total fixed cost. Total fixed cost. And below this line, we have loss. Why? Because of this cost. You know that this R point, cost is this and revenue is this. So below this line, we have loss. And above this line, we have the profit. But where will be the equilibrium or break-even point? Y-axis, we have revenue and cost. X-axis, we have rate of output or quantity, and this R is the total fixed cost here, and total cost is like this one. It is start increasing and after this point it start decreasing. Now see this point here, up to here the total cost is more than total revenue maybe, and even this loss because of revenue. This green line is less than this blue line, so this whole area is loss because of total cost is more than total revenue. Here we have the break-even point. This here total cost is equal to total revenue. Here also total cost is total revenue. When total cost is less than total profit, then we have the total cost, then we have the profit. This area shows the profit. It means here the maximum profit, when the gap will be maximum between total revenue and total cost, then we have the maximum profit, and here is the maximum quantity, OQ quantity, the producer will get maximum profit. Here total revenue is more than total cost. Now another point here, again the total revenue, total cost, two equilibrium point here and here. Here the difference between these two, in this here you can see, after this equilibrium point the total revenue is increasing and total cost is decreasing. So producer should not stop the production here, although this is equilibrium point. Here also equilibrium point means this is also break-even point, this is also break-even point, but here at the Q3 total revenue to equal to total cost, but the major difference after this point, total cost is increasing, total revenue decreasing. Here total cost is decreasing, total revenue is increasing. So producer should not stop here. Producer can produce up to Q3. So hopefully you are able to understand this diagram. What is the break-even? Break-even means no profit, no loss. So there are two points, break-even here and here. But producer should produce up to Q3 quantity. Now let us explain briefly. In the given graph, if firm attained break-even point twice, we have discussed. When the firm, its production Q3 or level of production was Q1, Q3, we have discussed. The difference between total revenue and total cost is profit, we know. When the output was Q1, the firm was incurring the loss. In the diagram we have seen, up to Q1, OQ1, the firm has loss. OQ2 is the maximum profit, OQ3 is the optimum break-even point. Now, when the firm produces OQ2 level, the firm attain maximum profit, and to attain the highest level of profit, so firm should continue producing at the same point, that is Q2 point. Now, break-even analysis is widely used to determine the number of units the business need to sell in order to avoid the losses. To calculate the required business to determine the selling price, variable cost and fixed cost is very, very important. So with this, let's conclude this whole lecture, whole topic. We have discussed in this module in detail revenue. By selling of a commodity, whatever money a firm receives is called revenue. In the whole lecture, we have discussed that by selling of a commodity, the amount of production or the quantity produced by a firm, whatever money a firm receives is called revenue after selling the product or commodity. Total revenue, we have discussed the whole value of firm sale, total value of firm sales. And the margin revenue, change in total revenue resulting one, or maybe there will decrease or in increase in quantity sold, that is called the margin revenue. Change in total revenue due to change in quantity, that is the marginal revenue. Average revenue, total revenue divided by quantity sold. Per unit revenue of the product is called as the average revenue. We have also discussed the economic profit versus accounting profit. Economic profit means total cost minus explicit plus implicit cost. But in case of accounting profit, total cost minus, yes, so total revenue minus explicit cost only. Economic profit, total revenue minus explicit plus implicit cost. But in accounting profit, total revenue minus explicit cost only. The implication of break-even analysis has also discussed. Break-even is the point which a firm makes no profit or no loss. So we have also a detailed discussion on the break-even analysis with diagram. Break-even analysis. The break-even analysis helps a firm to understand interrelationship between the firm revenues and the cost and operating profits. Break-even analysis also helps a firm to understand the interrelationship between firm's revenues, costs, and operating profits. So with this, thank you very much. Thanks for your attention.